Thus, the first two stanzas of the poem paint the picture of a great house, of a supposedly great house, an allegedly great house, populated by an obviously sprawling family, whose members appear to be acquisitive, covetous, greedy, disorganized, cluttered, and perhaps also somewhat crazy. You must remember that A.K. Ramanujan was a man who rejected his own identity. His own identity as a Brahmin, his own identity as an Iyengar. This rejection expresses itself in his formal rejection of the beliefs of his family and his ancestors as a very young man. In his decision to go abroad, in his decision to settle abroad, settle in the United States, in his decision to marry outside his caste, even outside his religion. It is this rejection which is the fuel for this poem. The poet now tries to give examples of how things which come into the house refuse to go out. He begins with cows. You must remember that in India, the bovine and the divine have always been closely connected. And in the first half of the 20th century, many Brahmin houses had goshalas, places where cows were kept and cows were looked after and cows were worshipped and cows were cherished. A goshala is not a cowshed. It's much more than a mere cowshed. Lame wandering cows from nowhere and founding a goshala, starting a goshala, was looked upon as a very high punya, one of the highest punyas from the Brahmin perspective. And here, what do we find? Lame wandering cows from nowhere. Cows probably very old. Cows which have been abandoned. Cows which nobody wants. Lame. They can't walk properly. They're too old. And perhaps they're also injured. Lame wandering cows from nowhere have been known to be tethered. Tethered means tied with a rope or with a chain so as to restrict its movement. Given a name. See how the cow is loved and how the cow is cherished. Encouraged to get pregnant. Encouraged. The stanza ends there, but the line does not end there. Another example of enjambment. The idea flows from the third stanza freely into the fourth stanza. Encouraged to get pregnant in broad daylight, because the process has to be seen clearly, not in darkness, not at dusk, in the broad daylight of the street, quite publicly, in a very public manner. It is an event. It is an exhibition, rather. It is a show. The broad daylight of the street, under the elder's supervision. There lies the joke. The elders of the family, who always try to impose restrictions on the junior members of the family, are very much interested in sex themselves. And they simply enjoy the process of supervising the cows becoming pregnant, being impregnated by bulls. The girls hiding. Of course, the girls are very shy. The girls of the family are very modest, very shy. They are embarrassed by the very thought of sex, the very idea of sex, the very idea of a cow being made pregnant embarrasses them, and so they hide themselves. Enchantment again. The girls hiding behind windows. They could very well hide behind walls, but they hide behind windows. They choose to hide behind windows. The windows are not open, because if the windows are open, the elders would see them and take them to task. The girls hiding behind windows with holes in them. This is vintage Ramanujan. The girls are so embarrassed by what is happening that they hide themselves in shame, but they hide themselves again against windows, and of course the windows are shut. They would not dare to open the windows and draw the attention of the elders who are supervising the cow being made pregnant. Of course, I think the elders are so engrossed that they may not even notice if the windows are opened, but the girls don't want to take that risk. The girls hide themselves in shame behind the closed windows. The windows are closed, but the windows very conveniently have holes in them. The girls are as much interested in sex as the elders of the family are. I think that the lines hint at the moral decay of the family. The elders of the family probably try to impose restrictions on the junior members of the family. The elders of the family probably preach, the poet does not say that, but probably preach moral rectitude, sexual rectitude, but are very much interested in sex themselves. And nothing thrills them more than animal sex. The girls of the family pretend not to be interested in sex, pretend to possess moral rectitude, sexual rectitude, pretend to be embarrassed by sex, but are as keenly interested in sex, in animal sex, as the elders of the family are. I think that the lines throw a hint at the moral decay of the family, at the indecency that the members of the family are capable of. It is indeed a great house. There cannot be any dispute on the matter.